Fortress is a 1992 released action sci-fi directed by Stuart Gordon.
Yes, it's set in the future. We're never told exactly when. I guess, you know, whatever year it is, we've probably passed it now, haven't we?
Well, like, I think it says 2017 somewhere.
Does
I was
it?
Reading on Wikipedia
oh, well,
or something.
There you go then. So
last year.
Yes, so like a lot of these films, like Running Man and things like that, it's
we've now and
yeah, it's past. Like yes, we don't have flying cars or killer robots or, you know, murderous game shows or anything like that, unfortunately. No. or fortunately, I mean, sorry. So yes, so basically, there's a one-child policy in America, much like China had. Yes, Christopher Lambert and his wife are attempting to cross the border, I think, into Canada, aren't they? And they get caught because she happens to be pregnant and she's trying to cover it up. They have like special scanners to scan you and things like that. And so they get locked up in the fortress.
They do.
Which, unsurprisingly, for a sci-fi film, is a corporate-owned prison.
Yes.
They always are. So, and that's it, really. Yeah, he's locked up with a load of other undesirables or people who have done, you know, various minor crimes.
Yeah.
Like tax evasion and things like that.
Yeah.
And, yeah, this thing is like 30 stories down.
Out, into, out into in the middle earth. Of nowhere.
Yeah.
Right down under the ground.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, and is run or overseen by Clarence Boddicker himself.
Kurtwood Smith.
That's it.
Yeah.
Who's, yeah, a nasty piece of work. Not quite as nasty as Clarence Boddicker, but...
You might want to say, in case people don't know, that he's talking about Robocop.
Yes,
obviously.
Sorry.
Some people might not know.
No, well, a shame on you
exactly,
if you
yeah.
don't. Yes, so, and they've got cameras everywhere and things, and he can the amazing technology they've got can even see into people's dreams.
Yes.
So Christopher Lambert happens to be dreaming about his wife, and Kurtwood comes into his dream and tells him that, no, you're not allowed to dream about that, mate, sorry. Although not before he's had a little perv at it, obviously, because he's a bit of a pervy warden. So not only have you got the warden, you've also got, to keep the prisoners in line, they've got, they're fitted with intestinators.
Yes, pleasant.
Another sci-fi trope, where they're, you know, they have this detonation, you know, this detonation device forcibly inserted into them, and if they cross certain lines, then they're in pain, they get a sharp pain, and if they cross another line, then it explodes and kills them. So we get a demo of that early on in the film. And again, Kurtwood Smith's character can set off random intestinations whenever he wants to put people in discomfort. Yeah, so his cellmates are played by Tom Towles, who's in Henry Portrait.
Henry Portrait of a Killer is probably his most other famous
yeah.
film. He plays the friend of Henry.
Jeffrey Coombs, who obviously, you know, worked with Stuart Gordon a few times on Reanimator and From Beyond, things like that. And
Frighteners he was in.
He was in Frighteners.
It's great in the Frighteners.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
And Lincoln Kilpatrick, as, you know, the sort of, he's kind of like Morgan Freeman's character in Shawshank,
yeah.
where he's constantly
yeah,
promised parole, but never quite gets
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
And also Clifton Collins Jr., who... In this film, he was originally billed as Clifton Gonzalez.
Right, yeah, he's one of those actors that I think I saw him and I was like, who's that? I totally recognise
yeah.
that guy, but couldn't work it out.
Well, at the moment, he's in Westworld.
Oh, so, okay, because he was also, he turned up in Menace to Society and Dead Presidents in the 90s.
So, yeah, they you know, try and hatch a plan to escape, basically. And there's also, you know, there's as usual with any prison film... You know, there's some beefy guy who wants to, you know, abuse and
yeah.
destroy anyone else. And in this case, he's played by Vernon Wells, who you probably recognise from Commando.
Yes, or Mad Max.
Or Mad Max, yeah.
Weird Science.
And Weird Science, yes, yeah. yes.
Basically so. Playing the same character in all those films.
Pretty much, yes. And
still around today, still making
He is today. Letting off steam.
Yes.
Wherever he goes.
He does. He is.
So, yeah. So, it's, you know, that's it's your typical 90s sci-fi action film with probably because it's Stuart Gordon, it's got a bit more splatter
than
you would expect. Well, I don't know. Although, saying that, you know, things like Running Man and Total Recall weren't exactly shying away from
showing. No, no. And I mean, that's what I was going to say. Because I'm sorry, you know, when I saw this back when I, you know, in the early 90s, how old I would have been, like, you know, teenage years, I loved this film. It was one of those films really enjoyed. I mean, when I watched it again, I hadn't seen it for a while, I saw it again the other night, and yeah, it's not what I would look for in a film nowadays, but it's still enjoyable.
It's fun, isn't
it? I mean, it's one of those kind of dumb but fun films, and it's also, I mean, it clearly takes a lot from films you've mentioned, so obviously, you know, Running Man's got the neck collar, which explodes, doesn't it, if you get outside the perimeter or something. There's clearly, like, links to films like Total Recall. I always thought that so you kind of got films like Total Recall, Robocop, Terminator, they're like the big dogs of kind of sci-fi action films. But then underneath, you always got ones that were, you know, still had some great stuff in, had some good ideas in, but weren't maybe as good as the top ones.
I mean, you can see this clearly, like, as a lower budget.
Yeah, yeah. So this is kind of comes like Running Man and some of Schwarzenegger's other films. Apparently, Schwarzenegger was actually going to do this one.
Was he?
Yeah, I was reading that apparently he was a big fan of Reanimator, which features, I think, Arnie's stunt double is in Reanimator.
Right.
And he really liked it. And Stuart Gordon had the rights to this movie, or I think it was a novel. And Schwarzenegger, I think, helped. He said he was going to do it, and then they got a really big budget for it, and then at the last minute, Schwarzenegger was like, no, I'm not going to do that. So the budget went right down.
Oh, honey.
And they got Christopher Lambert instead. And in fact, there are certain moments in this film which you can kind of see, you think, oh, maybe Schwarzenegger would have done it quite
totally
well.
Totally would have been a standard Schwarzenegger film, wouldn't it? Exactly. Yeah, absolutely. But I think Christopher Lambert does a decent job.
Yeah, and Christopher Lambert, so, you know, obviously Highlander, he's a, you know, great in Highlander, which I actually haven't seen. It was one of those films that got away. And, of course, Tarzan, he played, which I have seen.
I think he's Raiden in Mortal Kombat as well.
He was that. But he was also in Subway, which is a really... It was one of...
Luc Besson.
Luc Besson's... I think it was his first film. And he's really good in that. I mean, Christopher Lambert. He's got the greatest voice in cinema history. Yes. One of those amazing voices. You just hear it and you're like, that's Christopher Lambert.
Yeah.
So he's great in it. And yeah, I mean, it's got a really good cast. It's got some really good fun special effects in. And that's what's great about these films. I mean, Stuart Gordon, obviously, he's not quite as body horror as David Cronenberg is, but there's certainly, you know, obviously, you know, Reanimator, and he's a fan of the gore.
Yeah, definitely.
He makes gory films. Yeah. And I think I prefer his horror more to this film.
So he's a big Lovecraft fan, isn't he?
Big Lovecraft. So he did From Beyond and Reanimator and Dagon, however you pronounce that. He also wrote Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Cool.
Which I quite liked when I was a little person.
It's still all right.
It's good fun film. But yeah, so this got some, like you said, it's got some kind of gory moments in it. It's a good fun, dumb film. If you don't want anything to really think about.
No.
I mean, it doesn't say as much as things like Total Recall. Obviously, Total Recall was written by Philip K. Dick, so there's more going on. There's more depth going on in there. No, it's a good fun early 90s romp-a-thon.
Romp-a-thon. Good phrase.
Yeah, so obviously, it's quite an old one. 1992 it came out, but what's the availability of it?
Well, you can pick up the DVD, I think, relatively cheaply. There was a Blu-ray released in the States a few years ago. I think it was exclusive to, I think it was Target or something. I can't remember what store it was exclusive to, but it's quite difficult to get hold of now. But it wasn't the best picture. It wasn't the greatest release. Personally, I picked up the German one, which... you know, the picture isn't amazing, but I think it's certainly better than the one that was released in the States. And it's got a couple of extras on it. It's got the trailer, and it's got an alternate ending. Yeah. But don't get excited, because it's literally the ending, but with some of the ending cut out.
Oh, that's right. Everyone's reading about that. Yeah, because the ending is not the strongest. I didn't think the ending was the strongest ending in the world.
No, but I thought the ending was that was on the film was better than the alternate ending, because it kind of just ends. It's a bit weird. It's a bit of a pointless extra, to be honest.
But apparently, on a Blu-ray, there is you spot something that you didn't spot.
Oh, I don't want to talk about that.
You don't want to talk about that?
No.
You big chicken. Apparently, there's something you can spot.
You'll know if you see it, because you can't unsee it. But this is the unrated version, so maybe that's why you can see it. Which has there's not a lot. I think, I don't know, it probably amounts to a few seconds of footage and a little bit of extra gore. But wherever they got that footage from is not quite the same quality as the rest. So you can definitely see a dip in the picture quality when that cuts in. But because it's only a few seconds, it doesn't, you know, it doesn't really affect it. It didn't really bother me that much. But no, I mean, if you want to get it on Blu-ray, this is the probably the best version to get picture-wise.
You know, we recommend it. You know, if you like, if you haven't seen it and you love films, well, if you like Schwarzenegger's films or any of those kind of 90s, end of the 80s, 90s science fiction action films, you know, you kind of know what you're going to get.
Yeah.
But it's a lot of fun. And, you know, Stuart Gordon is obviously, you know, he's an interesting filmmaker. We like his films.
Yeah.
So check it out. And if you do check it out, obviously come back and, well, if we recommended it and then you checked it out, come back and let us know what you thought of it or what you already think of it, if you like it. Do that. And check us out on social media.
Yeah, we're on Twitter and Facebook. There'll be some links to some of our other videos popping up at the end. So check those out.
Yeah.
And we'll be back in a week with another video.